Remember when China stopped taking our rubbish? China used to handle nearly half of the world's recycling. But in 2017, the government banned importing plastic waste. Instead, it focused on recycling at home, rolling out an ambitious new system in 46 cities.
可回收物的话，我们又分为了纸类、塑料、金属，还有纺织物。
The same year, with the goal of improving air quality, the government banned 28 cities in China's northeast from using coal for heating and cooking. Something they'd done for generations.
These are just two examples of how massive changes to environmental policy can happen almost overnight. But radical reform is not without risk.
For instance, the recent power outages across China are partly due to local governments scrambling to meet new emissions targets.
In China, the lack of opponent parties give a strange benefit for the party to implement things rapidly and effectively. But on the other hand, it remains challenges. Why? Because how can the supervisors be supervised?
Dr. Chen calls China's approach authoritarian environmentalism. It's almost the opposite of how we usually think about environmentalism. As a kind of protest movement.
Three, two, four, six.
Climate protests do happen in China, but they look less like that and more like this.
And I was rejected from going back to school because of the activism.
Oh Hong Yi started protesting when she was 16, inspired by Greta Thunberg's Fridays for Future movement.
It is just as much about our present and future missions as it is about our historic commissions.
That's seen her questioned and detained by the police in both China and later Switzerland, but she says she has no regrets.
We know what we do is for the public's benefit and for everyone's future.
While not a fan of protesters like Hong Yi, the government is promising action on the environment. Environmental policy has become an important part of China's international diplomacy, and also a symbol of the country's development and transformation, from a dumping ground for first world problems to a source of green solutions.
5 or 6 years ago, China has been considered as a laggard state in terms of environmental performance. Under Xi Jinping's administration, the kind of direction has been changed. State activism in promoting sustainable businesses such as wind power, solar power, or even nuclear power nowadays came considered as a new sources of soft power.
As an Australian, it's fascinating to see how this plays out in a country where there's no one really disputing the fact that climate change exists, in either the government or the media.
But while there's no climate scepticism, there's also not a lot of in-depth discussion of the dangers of climate change, even when people are feeling its deadly effects.
我那个病动的话需要以当地的这种知识，当地发生的气候的事件去传播给人们。行动的话还是第二步，最重要第一步就是这个理解这个问题，因为当我们看到这个 事情这么严重，这个气候危机这么严重的时候，我们自然也就会去行动。